In all this, I was so glad to hear that where flood has ravaged the place, people have now looked up to seeing how the soil is now infused with water, and they think they will have better returns in the farms. So the challenge has been seen as an opportunity, and I've just heard that being said by the Dharmadhikari, even as I sat next to them. If that is the way leadership is built among people, without crying victim, they've seen an opportunity. That itself gives strength, and I would think the banks should rush with loans to help them do the agriculture better. I hope they've heard me. I hope they've heard me, and I want them to rush to those places to say, oh, all right, the much before the water evaporates, much before summer sets in, take the money, do your agriculture, and earn your profit, and give me back my money also. So banks can also, as the villagers have felt it, should feel the pulse, be closer to those who lead the people, and be able to do business, core business, commerce, and therefore keep the chain, the virtuous cycle that was being said, cannot be touched otherwise. You can't remain far away from it and say, somebody build up the virtuous cycle. The virtuous cycle has to be built if we are closer to the ground. If we keep our ears on the ground, you know how the people are feeling now. In dry districts, in districts where water infusion is successful, rush with agriculture. And therefore, credit should not become an issue even when the other things are now favorable. So I do not want to take too much time. There are people who are well entrenched in the activities of the SHG. I hope this meet all the success, and I will certainly be keen to know what the outcomes of the discussions are. The experiences which are coming from all other countries are also equally important for us to understand how things work elsewhere, for us to also emulate them as and where we can learn the lessons. And I once again thank Dharmadhikari Heggade ji for having given me this opportunity to be with you all today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, madam, for your inspiring words. You are really a motivator for so many women in the society to come forward in their life. You are really a right person as an inaugurator of this great event. Thank you, madam. Now, moving further, SKDRDP is implementing for the last 1 year Prayas project of SIDB for the credit linkage of SHG members opting for micro enterprises. The loan will be available at 10% to SHG members. A special tie-up arrangement for rupees 100 crore is planned for this financial year. On this auspicious occasion, both the organization will exchange the MOU. In this regard, I request Shri Arup Kumar, GM SIDB, and Dr. L.H. Manjunath, Executive Director of SKDRDP, to exchange the MOU. And I request all the dignitaries to witness this moment. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Dear friends, we have now come to the great moment of listening to the greatest visionary, Dr.D.Veerendra Heggade, Dharmadhikari of Shri Kshethra Dharmasthala, the founder of Shri Kshethra Dharmasthala Rural Development Project. Dr. Heggade believes that dharma or worship should be in the direction of development. The uniqueness of Dr. Heggade is that every day he gets in touch with thousands of people, which gives him impetus to get in close touch with the society. He is always on the side that developmental organizations should always have the ground reality while designing the developmental plans. Friends, we have come to the most important part of this evening ceremony, presidential address. I, with due respect, request Dr. Veerendra Heggade ji to address the gathering.
Nama Kshetrada Shri Manjunatha Swami no Pratisi Indina E. Karakramadali Igatane Nama Dharmasala Kshetra the Bagge Hagu Nama Kshetra the Karakramala Bagge Mechuge Matugala Nuheli Taye Hage ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನವನ್ನು ನೀಡಿದ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ನಿರ್ಮಲಾ ಸೀತಾರಾಮ ಅವರೇ ಐ ಸೆಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಮದರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಪ್ರಿಷಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗಿವನ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಾನ್ಯ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳು ಈಗ ತಾನೇ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಉದ್ದೇಶಿಸಿ ಮಾತಾಡಿ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಲ್ಯಾರಿ ರೀಡ್, ಸೀನಿಯರ್ ಫೆಲೋ, ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಫಂಡ್, ಶಿಕಾಗೋ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ವೇ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ಲಿ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಎಸ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೆನಿ ಡೆಲಿಗೇಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಓವರ್ಸೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ, ಡಿಗ್ನಿಟೀಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಡಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಡಯಸ್ ಇನ್ ಧರ್ಮಸ್ಥಳ. ಐ ಸಿಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಹೆಗ್ಡೆ ಪೀಠ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಂಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟಸ್, ರಿಲಿಜನ್ಸ್, ಕ್ಯಾಸ್ಟ್, ಕ್ರೀಡ್, ಎಥೆನ್ಸಿಟೀಸ್. Sometimes I meet several hundred of people in a day. As Ramakrishna Paramahamsa said, Shivajnane Jeeva Seva, knowledge of God through service of man. The Heggades of Dharmasthala have believed in this philosophy and have tried to institutionalize this philosophy. For an organization which started its work in a remote rural village to help the vulnerable people from remote rural areas, to conduct a conference in this ambience and attracting people from all over the world is a humbling experience. For almost 4 decades, my organization SKDIDP has remained embedded in the grassroots. However, we remained innovative and never shirked from responsibility of tackling social issues which have troubled our society. Our innovations have led us to develop processes and technology. Our response to social problems have resulted in some outstanding movements like Janajagriti, Shuddh Ganga, Cleanliness Drive, Jnana Vikasa, to name a few. We have also followed a positive approach in partnering mainstream institutions. As a result, the SKDIDP stakeholders have immensely benefited from the ongoing schemes of the government and the programs of the banks, insurance companies, and pension intermediaries. Today, as I stand before you, I am looking at the past and at the same time towards the future. Post-independence, there was a revolution taking place in India, which was creation of abundant opportunities. I always say, if there is anything that has transformed India, it is creation of opportunities, more than the financial investment. All the plans of governments have ended up creating opportunities to the poor and vulnerable. Secondly, the new generation got education. In the 70s, there were not too many educational facilities in the villages. Establishing schools in the village level was a revolution. Higher education was unheard of in the rural sector. For example, for a law course, students had to go to Banaras. For a degree course, they had to go to Chennai. Compared to what we have today, not even 10% was available in those days. With educational institutions opening up at different levels, suddenly there was an opening of opportunities. In early days, 70s, people had no ambitions. They had no hope. They had no goal. Around this time, Land Reforms Act was brought into force. People who were tenants or wage laborers became the owners of the land in which they tilled. People developed attachment to the land later. It's my land. I have to invest in this. I have to develop this. I have to secure it for my future generation. Change the nature of their demand. These changes all happened in the 80s. So that was the time I really started to study villages very closely. In SKDIDP, we started giving inputs to improve the lands. Inputs like agriculture equipment, seeds were supplied. Knowledge transfer on use of seeds, fertilizers, irrigation, cultivation practices, and then lastly, marketing. Because they never thought of marketing, but now the process of production, higher yield, and marketing was also included in their agenda. This is the change that we brought through SKDIDP. Political leadership gave them the ownership of land and all the guidance, but they never thought of empowering the people. Empowering them was as important as asset ownership. So we took charge of the empowerment program. Independent India in the past has given everybody a great opportunity to prosper. Many have used this opportunity and have prospered. Food security, education, infrastructure, healthcare have all improved in our country. Three to four decades back, the people, especially from the vulnerable sector, were unable to make use of developments. Through SKDRDP, we have tried to educate the farmers and women to understand the schemes of the government and make use of the same. We have adopted the self-help group model since 1990. In this model, a group of women come together every week to discuss their issues and find solutions. As 18th century Scottish author Samuel Smiles has said, the spirit of self-help is the root of all genuine growth in the individual. The SHG movement has changed the mindset of the poor, and now they have become capable of using the facilities offered by the government. In other states, many other institutions would have done a similar work that our organization attempted to do in Karnataka. However, a lot needs to be done to create awareness among everybody to make use of the opportunities available in the environment. Even though SKDIDP has been promoted by a temple, I have always guided my workers and the stakeholders to become self-reliant. I tell them to always remain updated and not to show the dependency syndrome. In our programs on farmers, we have encouraged them to look for many subsidiary occupations which keeps them engaged all through the year. This has helped the members of the SKDIDP family to increase their incremental incomes from the farming activities. In fact, multiple incomes are the hallmark of interventions of SKDIDP. Still, there are many issues which are challenging us. For instance, market for agricultural producers have been a matter of grave concern affecting the poor people. Every farmer expects remunerative prices for his produce. In a free market scenario, quality works better than sympathy. Therefore, the farmer should pay attention to the quality of his product by concentrating on post-harvest technologies, packing, and presentation as much as works in the field. Intervention in the value chain is another important requirement. The poor people and the farmer cannot be dependent on the government forever. From this context, the philosophy of SKDIDP becomes very significant. Going forward, we have many challenges to conquer. Population is one such challenge. Although our population has a majority of young people, motivating them to be productive has been a great challenge. Former President of India, Dr. APJ Kalam, has written, "We will be remembered only if we give to our younger generation a prosperous and safe India, resulting out of economic prosperity coupled with civilization heritage." In this context, the emphasis given by our central government for development of skill among the young people is laudable. We in Dharmasthala, in collaboration with the Syndicate Bank and Canara Bank, started the Self-Employment Training Institute 4 decades back. These institutes provide entrepreneurial training to young people to start enterprises. This movement has now spread over the country by the name RCT, Rural Self-Employment Training Institute. These institutes are supported by the banks. As on the date, we have established more than 650 such RCTs. Cumulatively, we have trained 3.5 million young people to change their attitudes and embrace micro-enterprises. I believe young people have to change their mindsets and adapt themselves to newer